Let's talk about my journey as a mechanical engineer in the last 12 months. So if you don't know me, I am Prashant. I am a mechanical engineer. I am also a full-time freelance CAD designer and 3D printing enthusiast. Since I am a freelance mechanical engineer, I got a chance to work on multiple projects this year from different industries. So basically the year started with a board game development for one of the clients from USA. For them, I had developed a simple board game that has to be manufactured using laser cutting. Just after that, I got a chance to collaborate with one of the company from Australia. They were into effluent treatment plant design, installation and commissioning. I supported them in 2024 for about 6 months. Just after that, I got a chance to work with a very interesting company, Indian startup. They were into development of custom 3D printers. And I got a chance to work for them also. I had prepared and reviewed some of their designs and drawings. In parallel with those projects, I was also working with one of my oldest clients. Actually, they are from into landscape business. They used to develop landscape designs for them. I work as the design, drawing and detailing engineer. I use SolidWorks for their projects since I already own SolidWorks Maker's license. So I did lots of projects for them also in 2024. In addition to that, a very early stage startup from one of my neighboring state, Kolkata, has approached me for their patented design, and they want me to develop that a design and also a 3D printable prototype. So using Fusion 360, I had helped them to develop that design, and they were very happy after the final product, after the final prototype. In the past few months, I also got an opportunity to deliver training in Bhutan, that is my neighboring country. I visited there. I had provided 5-day long training on AutoCAD 3D. The employees were all from hydropower projects, and they were very happy with the content that I had delivered, and they had provided me very good feedback. Then in the last month, I also got a chance to work on one of the most challenging projects this year, and that project was related to gear mechanism design. So I had worked on the project, I had solved that problem, I had solved that gear ratio that they wanted to achieve with all the size constraints and everything. I had 3D printed that gear also, tested that design, and then I had delivered that product to the client's location. Also, I had given them all the digital files and everything that I had designed and did for them. I also supplied them all the calculations or the whatever the research that I did on the background. Then after that, in the last month, I also got a chance. One of the person from Dubai, UAE, they had approached me to develop a photoreactor design using Fusion 360. They wanted that complete design onto Fusion 360 only. So I had developed that also. But since I had signed a non-disclosure agreement with that client, so I cannot share much detail about that project. So these were all the projects that I had completed in last 12 months. Apart from this, there are few things, few goals that I had achieved in 2024. So the first goal that we had achieved, we had reached 3000 subscribers on YouTube. So thank you so much to every one of you. Because of you, it was not even possible. So the next goal that we had achieved, we are starting a new startup this year, that is Gulf Nest Engineering Private Limited. And we also got approved for the seed fund from the state government. So in the coming few months or in the new year, we are going to produce lots of content about different 3D printers and different technologies as well. We are going to procure new printers because we are going to receive funds, and we are also going to create lots of contents, learning contents. Some will be paid and some will be free for you. So stay tuned, watch our channel, subscribe to our channel, because we are going to generate lots of contents, lots of learning for you. So there are a few things that we had procured, purchased this year. And if we talk in terms of softwares, we had procured Fusion 360 commercial license this year. I had also purchased SolidWorks Maker's license this year because I don't want to use the crack softwares or the illegal softwares. I had also purchased few equipments and accessories this year so I can increase the quality of the content that I am delivering to you. So the first thing that I had purchased this year is this 3D printer that you can see on my back. So this is basically a Delta 3D printer. It's FLSun SR 3D printer. So I had not purchased this printer as new. I had purchased this printer from one of my old friend, and I got this deal at a very good price. And the print quality is very nice, very good. All my 3D printing projects I am completing on this 3D printer only. Now the next and one of the most expensive investments that we had did this year is on our desktop PC setup. On this PC I had invested because whatever the projects, big projects I am receiving with multiple parts and assemblies, just to handle those things I had invested on this PC, desktop PC. The next investment that I had did is on this wireless mic. It's from Vogue company. It comes with two mic and receiver, and since it's a type C mic, I can directly attach this to my phone. Now the next most valuable investment that I had did is this external storage SSD device. It's from Crucial, of 500 GB storage space. So this is basically very small in size and very handy. I can carry this with me all the time. Since the transfer speed is very good, I don't have to wait lots of time just to transfer my files from my phones to my PC. This also comes with type C connector, so I can directly connect this with my phone and transfer all my files whenever and wherever I need. And the last and one of my most favorite investment that I did this year, that I had bought iPhone 15. So the reason that I had bought this phone, just to increase my video quality. I was recording my videos earlier on to my Android devices, but since I used to record for longer hours and the phone was getting heated. But after buying this iPhone, I can create videos for longer hours. I don't have to worry about the performance and all those things. The only thing that I had to worry about is the storage that I had already solved using this SSD device. So these are all the equipments that I had bought in 2024 in the last 12 months. And now I'm going to talk about my plans for the coming year 2025. First skill that I want to learn is Blender software. I want to master Blender. I want to learn how to create animations, how to create organic shapes and models using Blender software. So that is my next goal that I already started working on that. I am planning and I am watching tutorials on YouTube. I am following the path by which I can learn the Blender. Since I do have lots of projects active, I can work on those projects using the Blender software and I can start getting good in that software. So that's my next thing that you will be, what if you are following me, you will be seeing lots of content around Blender also in the coming year 2025. My second plan for the 2025, I will work a little bit on my health side. I will work more on my fitness. I will join gym and maybe I will start running and I will work on my core strength. So this is my secondary thing that I will be focusing in 2025. So these are the only two things that I had planned so far for the 2025. I'm not planning very big. I just want to start very small. So let me know if you have any questions or anything that you want to ask with me. If you want to know about me, just comment below into this video. I will try to answer that. And if you are a mechanical engineer, just like this video, press the subscribe button, because that is the only way you can support me, guys. So thank you so much. Thank you so much for watching up to this point. Thank you.